So we are going to go ahead and check out essentially what the group situation is right now that both Vietnam and New Zealand are currently in, as we are going to be transitioning over to the next section where we're going to be able to see that they are in the group 7, I believe, whilst also being part of Netherlands and Switzerland. So another two great teams right there. Switzerland, I believe, is the more newer one, so very good to actually see, like you said, David, these more newer established teams coming up on the front and being able to cross that first stage of the qualifiers, essentially.
Indeed, exactly. And I think this particular group as well is quite interesting because I think, as you said as well, a lot of the newer teams are in this group too, based on who we've seen. We've got the Netherlands, New Zealand, Switzerland, Vietnam as well, I know, are all very, very much new. So I don't have any kind of preconceptions going in as to who should be on top here, who we'd expect to win. It's a complete open book. I love it.
No, exactly that, as we are going to be going ahead and seeing what the current scores are right now, if, of course, any of the matches have been played out, which they have not, between Vietnam and New Zealand. So this is going to be the first one right now that we will be able to feature, of course, live, and check out to see what kind of strategies both these trainers are going to try to implement, because, of course, both countries and all countries, essentially, do know that there is that pre-existing information available to them about what their opponents could have ran in previous weeks. So there may even be potential counter-teaming actions and team-building situations going on, which can definitely, essentially render effective, and change the course of results between these two teams.
Glad you said that, Costa, because that's definitely something that could happen here, as we've seen from previous weeks that Trung Lay actually has used the same team both week one and week two. So who knows, he might even use the same team again. He might be very confident with it. So it's on Satoshi's end to maybe he's built something that has something that's quite good versus his Kyoga teams that he's been using.
Oh, definitely. Definitely that. So what we are going to be doing is, of course, we're going to be going into the player profiles right now so we can get this highly anticipated match for you people. We do have Trung Lay starting off. And like you said, David, we do see a very familiar team. Is this the exact same team he's been using then?
It's not the exact same team, no, actually. I think he had Shedinja in his matches versus Ireland and versus South Africa as well. So he's obviously switched it up a bit. And it's actually quite a familiar six as well. So if for anyone who's been watching some of the Pokemon Twitch stream tournaments going on, because this may even be the winning team, six at least anyway. So he's forgotten that Shedinja, and he's got the Weavile, the Serena, Urshifu, a very strong six of core here. And it's not a team that you necessarily have to run the exact same spreads on as well. We could see maybe a Mystic Water on the Kyogre, maybe a Sash on the Weavile, who knows? And Trung Lay's been quite an effective team member for Vietnam too. He's, even though he lost his week one versus Tom Dowling in Ireland, week two he did win versus South Africa.
Yeah, exactly that. And I do believe it may be Santino's winning team, like you did say, of the Pokemon Invitational 25th event, of course. So, like you said, room for variations and adaptabilities when it comes to the team, as we are going to be going over to their opponent of today, Satoshi Ari of New Zealand, which is going to be rocking a very nice Pokemon there that I'm very, very excited to see. That Latias, accompanied by the Zacian, the Rillaboom, Suicune, Incineroar, and the Nihilido.
Yeah, I love that Latias. Not something that is often seen here. An excellent tailwind setter and overall really nicely bulky, especially that with that dragon typing there. Satoshi for New Zealand has unfortunately lost both his weeks that he's played versus the USA and Australia, but those were tough opponents in Ashton Cox and Fred Zhao as well. So I'd say there's nothing to shake a stick at here, especially with a very strong team and that Zacian too. And again, that Nihiligo is the third time he's brought that as well. He's had that on every single one of his teams too. So he's obviously really liking its mode on his team. And I think it may have some use maybe into this Kyogre team.
Yeah, I mean, Nihiligo is just one of those Pokemon in the meta as well that it just threatens a lot of Pokemon with that very fast rock typing that it does carry, especially with that Power Herb plus Media Beam combination that we have seen just skyrocket it straight up to plus one of special attack and potentially even threaten the KOs.
Oh, yes, exactly. And now let's get into team preview here, where we are now seeing from Trung Lay's end his team, the Kyogre, the Tornado, Serena, Rillaboom, Weavile, and that Urshifu. And interestingly, I don't think we've actually confirmed whether it is the single strike or the rapid strike from the team preview set yet. But on Satoshi's end, it is that Zacian, Latias, Rillaboom, Suicune, Incineroar, and Nihiligo. So I'm thinking about leads at the moment, Costa. What are you thinking?
Just the same. I'm just thinking, I'm really looking forward to seeing if the Latias is going to be brought here, because especially if it does, for example, try to profit off of any sort of grassy seed, if there's any sort of interaction there, it could be quite bulky when it comes to its physical defensive side. But Latias, I think it's just one of those Pokemon where it's quite defensive, it's quite good, unless of course the Kyogre does opt to go for an Ice Beam into it, but there's a lot of room for adaptability, even maybe try to get a Tailwind up or even threaten with Icy Wind.
Yeah, I think so. And Kyogre being unknown whether it's Choice Scarf or Mystic Water is something that's going to be really in Satoshi's head here as well, as the game plan can completely change because of that. Suddenly a Protect comes out, suddenly a massive amount of damage comes out. Who knows what's going to happen from this game, as you'd expect to, your opponent would know the six that has been used to win this huge Pokemon tournament, but we now do see the leads.
Yeah, the leads are that Latias there, accompanied by the Rillaboom over on Satoshi's side, whilst over on Tron's side, we do have the Tornadus Incarnate and the Weavile, and of course we do see the Grass Train now being brought onto the field.
Yeah, no Grassy Seed initially activated, but as we do see on Trung Lay's end, he does have the faster Fake Out here, so he's very much in the driver's seat here, and also the faster Tailwind as well, so he's definitely going to be able to get the speed control he wants if he wants it this turn, and be able to make sure he gets it up by faking out the Rillaboom if he chooses to do so. But we now do see a switch out.
Yeah, so the Serena does come in here, maybe anticipating that Fake Out from Satoshi's side, but no, Satoshi actually opts to go for the Zacian switch in here, maybe anticipating that Weavile trying to secure that slot. And of course, the Intrepid Sword does activate, will be bringing that Zacian up to plus one. No Fake Out from the Weavile, just a raw triple axel second hit. Moving on to a third one, but wait, we see a Berry proc from the Latias, which may be enough to allow it to survive a third hit, of which we don't even see, David, as the Icy Wind will be the choice of move from the Latias. Deals very good chip damage onto that Serena, indicating it may not even be an Assault Fist variant as well.
Indeed. I really like that play from Satoshi there as well. He knows that Trung Lay has Tailwind of his own as well, so if Trung Lay was to go for it right then, such as he went for his too, there'd be a bit of a standstill, wouldn't be much of a trade-off. In this game of Tailwinds, you really want to have your Tailwind staggered to be the one going off last, so that you always have that extra turns towards the end that you can really make the most of, as you know how each Tailwind turn is going to end and you can play towards that. So I like it. Going for the Icy Wind as well means that he can get a speed drop on two Pokemon, obviously, and get the Tailwind up last, but also still outspeed even if Tornadus went for its own Tailwind. So I really like that too, and obviously he knew that he was going to live that triple axel thanks to that Citrus Berry hiding in the back there for that Latias. And now he brings the Zacian, which resists these Pokemon pretty nicely too.
Oh, as we are going to be seeing the Latias opting to switch out for the Suicune right here. Of course, if there's any sort of triple action going into that slot, it will be able to resist it, as we do see Serena now switching back out for the Tornadus in its spot. Coming onto the field, Behemoth Blade will be unleashed onto this Tornadus, not even picking up the KO actually, allowing it to survive on 7 HP as the Triple Axel does connect all three times this turn round, but onto Suicune, which is so bulky in general, but especially with that resist, is an excellent switch for Satoshi.
Definitely. Satoshi's making excellent switches at the moment. However, Chung Lei does manage to get his Tornadus in just about alive, so it's able to get up a Tailwind. Mm. And if Tornadus does also go down this following turn as well, that might actually be quite good for Chung, because he might be able to get his Kyogre in and dish out a lot of damage versus Satoshi's Restricted, which is on the field. However, Suicune is another Pokemon that can offer a lot of speed control on its own end. It also gets Icy Wind, it also gets Tailwind, so this could be the moment where Satoshi also goes for it as well, enabling his Zacian, if the Kyogre isn't Choice Scarf, to outspeed as well.
Yeah, as Tron is going to be opting to get that prankster Tailwind now on the field, as Weavile opts to go for the Lash Out into the Suicune here. This may just be a ploy of trying to get any sort of damage dealt onto that Suicune to try to wear it down slowly yet surely, as it will in return be KO'd from that Behemoth Blade from the Zacian, of course, super effective Steel Typing onto that Ice Typing, as the Suicune just goes for the very raw Snarl, which of course at the HP range that Tornadus was at was more than enough to pick up KO, as it is going to be getting that tiny bit of recovery thanks to the Rillaboom's Grass Terrain.
Yeah, and that's a double KO for Satoshi, which is a huge turn for him. However, Chung has now got up his Tailwind, so it is now up to him to get for these last three turns of Tailwind to really make the most of it, as Satoshi does not have a Tailwind up on his own. And now with Kyogre coming in, whether you're Choice Scarf or not, it's going to be doing a lot of damage. It's going to be hitting first, which means its Water Spout's going to be very powerful. And with the Serena out in the field, which is exactly the perfect partner that you want in this format, it's not going to be able to hit by those grassy glides that the Rillaboom of Satoshi's might have that's in the back. However, this Zacian could be pretty bulky, as a lot of Zacians are at the moment, so it likely will live this Water Spout here. But with the grassy terrain up, and especially if this Serena has Grassy Glide as well, maybe a double up will be enough to pick up this Zacian, but there's the Protect.
Yeah, it goes for the Protect. It wants to try to stall out the turns of Tailwind, as the Grassy Glide will be coming out, and it is enough in the Grass Terrain. Ooh, critical hit there. I'm not sure if that mattered. That may have been close, but for me, I just think if it's a well-invested Serena there, it should be able to pick up the KO due to that Grass Terrain boost accompanied by it. As we saw, the Water Spout from Kyogre was just essentially met with the Protect.
It was, exactly. So I like the play from Satoshi just to protect his Zacian, bringing something that really supports the team a little bit more. And he does bring in the Latias this time, which does resist water, and it resists that grass as well. So if Chung Lei's Kyogre is Choice Scarf, it has to Water Spout here and will likely not pick up the KO on this Latias, which has very high special defense. And if it's also able to outspeed the Serena with this Tailwind, it can get off a huge Icy Wind or maybe a Tailwind of its own. However, I think it's probably not that fast, especially if Serena is running a little bit of speed here. So Chung is still very much in the driver's seat, unless Latias also has Protect.
As we're going to be seeing Zacian now switch out for the Rillaboom. So Rillaboom will be able to take this Water Spout quite nicely, actually, as the Latias, of course, resisting the Water Typing, is in a prime position to maybe do something, unless it doesn't get caught out with the Triple Axel, which it does. And both hits do connect there from the Serena, being able to successfully take it out of game one and forcing Satoshi now to bring in that Zacian yet again. But then again, David, I think Satoshi is trying to go for the play of wasting the Tailwind turns and maybe trying to get any sort of damage onto that Kyogre. Perhaps the Zacian may even be carrying that play rough.
Good indeed, and that's what he could really need to really bring back this game. Or even the Wild Charge as well, which would probably pick up the one hit KO as well.
Yeah.
There is still another turn of Tailwind here, as Trunks kindly reminded us of. And the grassy terrain for Rillaboom is gone, which means it's not getting that huge boost to its grass type move. So even if it had a non-priority move like a Drum Beating or Wood Hammer, it may not actually pick up the KO anymore, depending on the investment of the EVs of these two Pokemon. But Zacian goes for another Protect to start this final turn of Tailwind.
Yeah, as we're going to see the Water Spout yet again coming out. This is going to probably be a double up into the Rillaboom. I say that from the Serena right now. You don't lose anything by going for the play, as the Water Spout deals very good chunk of damage there. And yes, we do get the confirmation. U-turn, and it is enough as well. You see Tron opting to go for the U-turn rather than the Triple Axel, because they do not want to get the worser end of RNG in that case.
Indeed. And even though now Tailwind is gone, Trunks done an excellent job of bringing what was a 4-2 down to a 2-1 up now, which is amazing. Yeah. Showing the amazing effectiveness of the Water Spout. But as now Satoshi has now realized it is the Choice Scarf set, which does confirm it outspeeding the Zacian and doing a huge chunk of damage.
Oh, as we are going to see Playruff doing another huge amount of damage a hand there, but of course it's not enough because we do have the 2-versus-1 scenario that Rust Glide being more than enough to pick up a KO there. And essentially what we saw was just Trun go all out with the Tailwind mode, completely utilize it, and have the terrain on the field right next to that Kyogre.
Exactly. And I think that's what the whole Kyogre team is about. And Trunks obviously had a lot of success with it. And he's obviously very comfortable bringing Kyogre as well, week after week. And he's now just taken the game one win, which is amazing. He set up the Tailwind right at the right time, because especially as his opponent did not set up the Tailwind at all. And the Serena was saved for that Rillaboom, and Kyogre was just able to do exactly what it needs to do.
Well, exactly that. And I think that's what you just got to do. They're trying to set themselves up for that scenario. They did it quite well. And unfortunately, of course, their opponent wasn't able to slow that down as best as possible. They couldn't. They maybe could have played a bit more with the protects if possible. But we saw Zacian attempt to do that. It didn't come out to much fruition there because you just couldn't stop, that Kyogre mode under Tailwind. Maybe the Latias, if it did have access to Tailwind, for me, it may have been a sort of at least attempt to try to go for it, because you have to try to potentially match Tailwinds and try to slow down this Kyogre team's momentum, because that's what it's all about. Get the speed going and just deal the damage.
Absolutely. And what's really nice about this Weavile as well is that it threatens a lot of damage into the Latias, into the Rillaboom, and it offers that fake out as well. So it's an excellent lead, and it also outspeeds pretty much everything here other than that Zacian. So I really like his lead from game one, where he could lead the Tornadus. So if that Weavile is all that Tornadus is unchecked, it can Tailwind up, and as soon as anything goes down, Kyogre comes straight in, which you really want to deny. So I think Satoshi needs to really play a game of not allowing this Kyogre to come in for completely unharmed for free. Yeah. And dealing out a lot of damage. And I think he can do that as well. He has a lot of bulk on his team. He's got that Suicune, he's got that Latias, and probably a bulky Zacian too. So he definitely has the tools.
Yeah, as we are going to be seeing those tools being used on the lead, the Latias and Suicune over on Satoshi's side versus the Weavile and Kyogre. So we've got full speed momentum coming out from Trun's side versus the bulkiness of Satoshi's Pokemon.
He does. So Suicune is a very bulky Pokemon, and is likely going to be taking the water moves for days. However, Kyogre is not yet locked into anything yet with that Choice Scarf, and as we can see, Thunder is an option. However, Suicune often maybe carries the Wakan Berry, which reduces those electric-type super effective hits, so that could be an option, but Suicune is also immune to the fake out with its inner focus, so let's see what happens this turn.
Oh, this may be a double up. Ice Beam from the Kyogre goes into the Latias, followed by that triple Axel. It will be proccing the Citrus Berry, getting that recovery back. But of course, that was just after the first hit of triple Axel. It's all about if it can connect the next two. The second one does, and the third one will successfully pick off that Latias just straight off from turn one. But then again, the Suicune is just been free essentially to get that Tailwind up and have the speed advantage finally versus Trun's Pokemon.
Yeah, it's been a complete switch of who's got up their Tailwind and then now has that switch in to really make or really capitalize off that speed control that's just been given to them. So, and especially if this Weavile is not Focus Sash, if the Zacian's coming in, it is looking very nice because the Choice Scarf Kyogre has locked itself into Ice Beam, which is not very good versus either of these Pokemon. It's got to switch out if it wants to do anything in the rest of this game. And Weavile is sitting in front of a potential one-hit KO if the Zacian decides to target it here. So Satoshi's very much in the driver's seat, and he probably knows it too. Weavile rarely carry Protect. He knows the Kyogre can't Protect either, so it's his opportunity to maybe position, get something a bit more offensive than his Suicune in, and do a lot of damage out with this Zacian at the moment. Potentially into the Kyogre slot, which is quite safe. You can damage it if it decides to stay in. Maybe something comes in like the Tornadus, for instance, to try and get up their own Tailwind, because it does live that Behemoth Blade. So I would maybe see that here.
Yes, we're going to be seeing the Kyogre now switching out. The Rillaboom has switched in. It may, of course, be able to take any sort of attack coming out from the Zacian if it is bulky enough, as Weavile just opts to go for the Feint there. Quite interesting, maybe anticipating that Protect coming out. Just wanted to guarantee some KO there. But, of course, that may be the case due to the Tailwind. It was expecting the KO being dealt onto it, as we see the Rillaboom does just barely survive. But wait, we have the follow-up, and it does not, from both the Suicune and the Zacian there, focusing down that slot, being able to guarantee that KO onto any switch the Kyogre would have wanted to try to opt for.
Yeah, I love that play from Satoshi, because Weavile's not really offering a lot here. It's neither of its stab attacks hit Zacian for much damage at all, and the Kyogre definitely wants to switch out, so you know something threatening is going to come in from that slot, so he doubles into it, and it's probably going to be a grass type because there's both a Serena and a Rillaboom, and he's able to take out a huge pawn that Trung has here. And Weavile is still sitting on the field, still not offering a lot of damage output, and Satoshi's leaving it there because he knows he can, and maybe that Feint was a bit of a last-ditch effort. He thought Weavile would probably get targeted. It's going to go down. It'll get a little bit of chip off, because I know that's then, especially from that water spout from earlier, that single target water spout was almost a KO. So plus the Feint chip, that may have been enough to guarantee it, but across the terrain, just healed it straight back up.
Yeah, as the Kyogre now thinking that it can switch in safely into the Weavile slot, does just that. Grassy Glide comes out, deals so much damage onto the Suicune. Grass Terrain boosted, which also gives it the priority as the Zacian goes for the Behemoth Blade yet again. Now into that slot, hoping to pick up a KO onto the Weavile, but then again, dealing so much damage onto Kyogre, which resists. We have a double up again. Now the Kyogre cannot run away from what it seems from Satoshi's Pokemon, as the Scald was able to deal some very respective damage, taking advantage of that weather setup with the rain.
Definitely. And as we can see from Trunk again, he kindly shows us we've got one turn of talent left on Satoshi's end. However, Serena is in the grassy terrain, so it's able to get off a grassy glide before anything moves from Satoshi's end as well. So that Suicune can be picked off, but Zacian is in the driver's seat still and can still pick up a KO on this Kyogre now. Maybe not the Serena, because it does seem to be it's quite bulky, but Rillaboom is now the switch.
Yeah, so Rillaboom will be opting to potentially go for that threatened fake out the following turn, as Weavile is going to do the exact same. You have the pressure on the field as the terrain up does target down the grassy glide onto the Rillaboom slot, takes it quite well. Behemoth Blade, which Pokemon is going to try to take out this time? We see it go for the Tarina slot, and it just survives on 4 HP, enough to go ahead and get its berry recovery activated there, and maybe even taking advantage of the grass terrain to try to get even more HP recovery going for itself.
It does. And grassy terrain reveals some speed interactions between the Rillaboom and the Serena, but now the Tailwind is up. It's still a bit unknown between who is faster between the Rillaboom and the Serena. So imagine the Serena probably lives a grassy glide here, but if it is able to get a triple axle before this Rillaboom attacks, it's could be still in the game for Trung here, because he has his Kyogre in the back. He definitely wants to deal with that Rillaboom. It's just this Zacian that's staring down a lot of Pokemon at the moment. It's still very healthy, and it is looking a little bit of a struggle here. Zacian needs to have some chip down on it of some sort. Maybe some sort of hacks to go there, maybe some freezes. I think it is looking tough for Trunk, but he still has a few Pokemon left.
Alright, we're going to be seeing the Suicune now coming in, maybe, of course, wanting to take any sort of U-turn dealt damage onto it, as, or should I say the triple axle there, which only hit once, and boy, what little damage did it cause and deal onto that Suicune, as Suicune's just going to be able to recover that bit, and even some more, from the grass terrain there.
It is, and so Satoshi just pivoted in Suicune again, able to get the Tailwind up potentially this turn, so the Zacian can outspeed Trung's Kyogre. However, the grassy terrain still being up, Serena is able to cover that Suicune slot with the grassy glide likely this turn, unless Satoshi decides to switch in his Rillaboom yet again. Weavile's used up its fake out turn, Zacian is just still probably able to take another KO this turn.
Wow, just like you said, Satoshi is trying to get those switches going to try to better their positioning right here. They're making the excellent reads right there. They're just expecting the standard play from Trun's side, and they're calling it every single time. The Rillaboom was able to take that grassy glide quite well. The Weavile does opt to go for the triple axel, got a cripple hit on the first time round, was able to connect with all three as the Zacian does finally pick up a KO onto the Tsarena. And all of a sudden, this means a lot of trouble for Trun if the grass terrain is still going to be on the field, but it may not, which may opt Satoshi to go for the switch in yet again.
It is. Interestingly, we haven't seen a second grass type attack from Satoshi's Rillaboom, so if it is just the grassy glide, this could actually work in his favor, having the grassy terrain gone, so he can actually hit the Gligar with his grass moves.
Yeah.
But Zacian is still in a very nice position because this Kyogre is going to have to resort to its other water type attack if it has one, other than the water spout, if it's going to want to deal with this Zacian. But it is rain boosted, it is faster than the Zacian still, so we shall see how much damage it is able to do here. But Rillaboom is now switching out.
Yeah, so Suicune is going to be brought onto the field right now. I think Satoshi may be banking on the Suicune somehow getting KO'd here, but the Kyogre opts to go for the Scald into that Zacian's Protect, and the Triple Axel comes up from the Weavile, will target down and successfully connect with all three hits onto the Suicune, but puts it within just enough range to get that Wiki Berry proc and recover so much HP back for that Suicune.
Yes, Suicune comes in with more health than it actually ends the turn with more health than it came in with. I mean, thanks to that very healthy berry of Suicune. So it's, to be honest though, Satoshi was probably hoping for the KO there. As you get Rillaboom in very safely next to your possession, it's just protected. You can cover something with a fake out, probably grassy glide the Kyogre for the KO. But now Trung's Kyogre is still in a position to go for the Scald and potentially get a burn as well, which may even then let it live the hit from the Zacian here. So an excellent pick for his second water move going into the final turns of this game.
Exactly. So Satoshi is going to have to hope not to get any sort of burns if it was targeted, but it wasn't. The Suicune was instead, as the Weavile goes for the triple axel into that now Rillaboom slot and successfully connects with all three hits. So Trun just trying to essentially expect the adaptation from Satoshi's side, as Satoshi Suicune will now though get that tailwind pressure going and will have all of the speed momentum that they may need to force this into a game three.
Absolutely. Trun called the turn very nicely there. Getting rid of the Rillaboom is pretty huge, but as you said, Satoshi is now able to bring in Zacian with the speed control that he wants. That's so he can now guarantee avoid the Kyogre's scalds and be able to pick up the KO that we've seen it be able to do in previous turns. The Behemoth Blade on its own did about a third, but it also has that Sacred Sword that it's able to use, which is has a little bit more power versus Kyogre as well. And Weavile is not going to be doing much back to it, even I'd say with a crit on every triple axel, which would be something to see.
Definitely will, as like you said, David, Sacred Sword checkmates that Kyogre. Kyogre's out of this game too, which will leave the Weavile all on its own. Scald in the rain deals so much damage, even just above half of its HP's worth. Triple Axel, like you said, no crits, which means the Suicune is now still on the field. And this is a very good turnaround for Satoshi.
It is. He's done exactly what Trung did in game one, basically. He got up Tailwind, and he had absolute control with his Zacian, and Zacian was just in the driver's seat, picking up KOs left, right, and center. So it'll be interesting to see what Trung maybe does for game three. We have not yet seen that Urshifu, which is likely that rapid strike, which we have seen on previous compositions of these six. So, and that is a good matchup into Zacian too. And I think having seen Behemoth Blade and Sacred Sword and no play rough yet, it could be a nice bring for him into this game three, I'd say, to be able to have a switch in for it and deal a lot of damage, especially with those rain boosted surging strikes. And I think if it's, especially if it's Focus Sash too, he's able to deliver a hit from the Rillaboom. So that would be my pick for the change up going to the next game, maybe over the Weavile, because if Satoshi leads that Suicune again, which seems to be very good for him, you can't fake it out anyway with Weavile, so you might as well bring something else that can just deal a lot of damage to it and something that can help with the Zacian a little bit more.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, in the end of the day, we noticed that, of course, the Tornadus was not brought in that game too. And evidently, Satoshi was able to win that over Trun. So, quite interesting. A bit of change up in the dynamic, essentially, of the four Pokemon that they decided to bring. I'm not sure if that was much to the detriment or not. Because, of course, in this scenario, we saw that Satoshi played excellently well. They were able to go ahead and double up in the correct slots, which just was able to essentially grab them so much momentum and be able to just win it out and force this game three.
Yeah, it kind of showed how the benefits, but also the negatives of Choice Scarf Kyogre. Especially once your opponent knows it's Choice Scarf, it's such a very safe slot to target. And especially if you know it's switching out, you know it's probably going to come in. And there seems to be just a general lack of protects or detects on Trunk's end. So once Satoshi is in a good position, it's very hard for Trunk to kind of get himself back into a good position or stall anything out because he has to make switches. But at the moment, with Satoshi's composition and his the move choices he's got in his Pokemon, he's able to cover for pretty much everything here. So I'd really like to see that Urshifu if I'm Trunk here. As we do see similarly to potentially game one for Satoshi here.
Yeah, I think so, as we do see Trun also lead with the Weavile and Tornadus. Now, of course, having the direct potential KO if opted to on, or should I say, not even KO, actually. We saw the interaction of that Citrus Berry on the Latias, which proved to be so, so crucial in order to survive that triple axel.
It did. It was huge. And now with the Tornadus here as well, it's a nice update for Trunk. He knows he doesn't want to be losing that Tailwind War anymore because once Kyogre's in good position, it is able to do so much damage versus this team. And there's a little Fake Out chip, which may make a difference later on, followed by Tailwind.
Yeah, as of course, the Icy Wind will come out from the Latias. It wants to slow play this a bit, I feel, because at this point, it's not directly threatened for a KO unless there's any sort of shenanigans of Hurricane essentially coming out from this Tornadus or even an Icy Wind, perhaps.
Yeah, I think so. Interestingly, I think we've only seen Icy Wind from this Latias so far, so it'd be interesting to see if it does actually have that Tailwind or what sort of offense it might have, because Latias has a lot of different moves it can run. You've got interesting moves like Mystical Fire or Grass Knot or Thunderbolt or Thunder even, so it's got a lot of options even for the rain matchup as a Dragon Psychic type.
But we're not going to see any more of its move pools just yet, or move choices, should I say, as it switches out for the Suicune, which is going to be taking that triple axel as if it's nothing. It's just scoffed it off completely as the Zacian goes for the Behemoth Blade. It will actually be outspeeding the Tornadus right now and picking up the KO2 whilst it's at it. Of course, that Icy Wind truly paying dividends in how both of those Pokemon were trained. That may have not even be a match speed Tornadus, whilst it could have been a heavily invested speedy Zacian there.
Indeed, and interestingly, Satoshi has now brought in his Weavile here. Satoshi brought in his Suicune. So he is able to get up the Tailwind now, and a little bit later than Trunk's end too. And it's not looking like Suicune is in range of a KO here either, especially if it's using that special defense side. I think it will probably take this Thunder if this is just a Choice Scarf, but we're going to have to see.
Yeah, as a Zacian opts to go for the Protect right there, so Satoshi very worried of getting hit by that Water Spout. As Trun, like you said, David, goes for the Thunder into the Suicune, just shy from picking up the KO. No Paralysis proc as well, which could have been quite detrimental if, of course, it was able to get that same unique rare full turn Paralysis, and of course the same turn, but the Suicune does get the Tailwind up right now. So Satoshi being able to just put in so much work with that Suicune.
Absolutely. A huge play as well. And luckily, because he hasn't brought in his Rillaboom yet, if it is in the back, this Serena doesn't have those grassy glides. And if it had, it wouldn't be able to really threaten this Suicune at the moment, but not this time yet. So Kyogre does have to switch out as it's stuck in that Thunder.
Yeah, as well as the Suicune for Satoshi's side, which will be the Latias coming straight in, but the Zacian opting to go ahead and try to get rid of any threats to that Latias, switching, goes for Serena, but once again, David misses the KO. Such a well-trained Serena, just going ahead and doing its job, getting that citrus berry recovery going, goes for the grassy glide, but unfortunately for Trun there, that was a good switch in for the Latias, and Trun maybe could have even opted for U-turn, but felt it wasn't the right time.
Yeah, potentially, actually. I would have liked that to see that positioning as well. But he does get in his fake out Pokemon Weavile, which is another way, despite having not many protects, he is able to stall out a little bit longer from this very threatening Zacian.
Yeah, as the fake out did go into the Zacian slot there, it is going to be flinching. And there it is. We've got another move revealed. David, Psyshock, and it picks up the KO on the Serena. So even if it was, let's say, an Assault Vest variant, it would have bypassed the special defense there and gone straight for that physical defense stat side, inflicting so much damage.
Yeah, I love that too. A very nice move to have, especially versus a Moongus as well, which has a little bit higher special defense and often runs a lot of special defense as well. So, but going into this next turn here, Latias is looking pretty nice here too, unless it will go down to this lash out. But look at this damage.
Oh my lord, critical hit. Oh, that Sacred Sword dealt so much damage, and the follow-up from the Psyshock may have, of course, meant that it might not have actually mattered as much, that critical hit, but of course, we do not know the investment of these Pokemon. Triple Axel, second hit connect onto the Latias, which, of course, will be proccing its Citrus Berry, and at this point, the third hit, I don't think will be, oh my lord, it is enough. It picks up the KO, gets rid of the Latias finally. But at this point, David, Trun has lost that Kyogre, which is such a huge damage output weapon, essentially, for their side of the field.
I think it is, yeah. It's a huge critical hit if it did matter there. Especially if Trun was maybe going for something like a Thunder into the Zacian. If there was a Paralysis there, that might have changed a little bit more. You'd have it for the Suicune in the late game as well, and then what resists it in that Latias or Rillaboom is covered by the Weavile. So I think Trun had an end game there going, but unfortunately, Zacian is just too strong.
Yeah, it really is. As it goes for the Protect right now, just trying to slowly end this game, play it out as best as possible. Triple Axel will go into Suicune, will connect all three times, but will not pick up a KO as the Retaliation dealt it with the Scald Burn is just going to put a bit more salt onto injury in that scenario. Rain does end, and Satoshi has been able to play this magnificently well.
He has, exactly. Really using that Suicune, I think, is probably the MVP, I would say, in this matchup. You've got, it just lives every hit and gets that really crucial speed control for his team as well. Triple Axel, going to the Suicune. Not doing a lot of damage.
Not doing much. I mean, at this point, it's just game over, essentially. The Weavile cannot, even in its wildest dreams, 2v1 versus a Suicune and the Zacian. And, of course, this will mean that Satoshi Ari is the winner of this first stream match, ladies and gents, and will be putting New Zealand up by one versus Vietnam's none.
Exactly, and what a win as well, his first win as well in this World Cup circuit too, so he must be feeling very chuffed with himself, especially and being on stream as well. So well done to Satoshi for taking this again, and versus a very strong team this time, as Vietnam have made it into the qualifiers, into the group stages even from the qualifiers. So but nothing to be said against Trung here, he played a really good set too, and I unfortunately think you could see that maybe with the Latias and the Suicune, both really good speed control options that are probably both good to bring versus Kyogre teams, that maybe he did do a little bit of prep there. And as you can see, it probably did pay off too.
Yeah, because we noticed in game one, Satoshi didn't, I felt like from Satoshi's side of the field, they didn't actually acknowledge that Suicune and Latias in combination with Rillaboom in the back can essentially win out this matchup in a way, because it's just so, so strong given the bulk and the usability of all the various moves that could go for speed control, even special attack disruption with that Snarl on the Suicune, had a lot of options, and they were able to honestly perform it so, so well in that game two and game three.
They did. And that, yeah, that puts New Zealand up 1-0 versus Trung Le and the team Vietnam. So it's a really good start. And that's probably a lot of momentum that has probably fueled New Zealand's fire to try and take their victory over Vietnam for this week, potentially.
Of course. So, of course, ladies and gents, that does mean we will be cutting to a very short break, and we will be back immediately with Chile versus Brazil. Don't go anywhere, and we'll catch you in a bit.